That's so true.
Oh,
an amazing summer. It is so good after traveling around the country all year to finally get back to the Pacific time zone, baby. That means we're close to home. But I'll tell you what, the combination of bands out here this year, I miss my family. We've been gone all summer, but I got a new family now with REO and Train. It's amazing, and we appreciate it. But I will tell you this, and this is just between you and me, right? I think I finally understand why the Train guys were so excited about touring with REO Speedwagon. You see, I think they figured that if they toured with us, that we would bring in a slightly younger audience. But I feel like I'm 22, baby. So here's my secret to longevity. It's simple. Wake up in the morning, put one foot in front of the other, and do the very best you can to live every moment.
Sure, Donna. Say, Romeo, what about your promise to the human woman dinner's club? I'm sorry, Spanky. I have to live my own life.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, please, if you will, direct your attention to my left on the lead guitar from Framingham, Massachusetts, Dave Amato. So Dave joined the Speedwagon back in 1989, and for the past 35 years, he's been coming out here rocking hard, kicking ass, taking names, the best guy you could ever have in a band with you. Say hello, come on, give it to him, Dave Amato. Now, Dave had a had made quite a name for himself around the country as a kind of a, we call him the Shred Master General. He just can play, can flat out play rock and roll. But Dave has another side to himself that I've gotten to know over the years. And this next song, we could never play this song live because no one could cut this lead guitar part. It's a slow song. It's got so much emotion. It's got, I couldn't write words for the chorus because the guitar part said it all without saying a word. It's the last song on side two of our High Infidelity record. It's called Wish You Were There.
Where you can go,
Thank you. So, you know, every young songwriter, every wannabe songwriter, which we all were at one point, we all write a bunch of shitty songs when we're kids, right? I had a song called My Little XKE. Now, you know, the list went on, but then there's that moment where you turn a corner and you write a song and you finish it and you play it all the way through and you're like, man, I think maybe I'm a songwriter now. And the song we're gonna play right now is what that song was to me. It's the song that got me the gig as lead singer in REO Speedwagon back in 1972. It's called Music Man. Thank you very much. So a couple years back we found ourselves in need of a new keyboardist here in REO Speedwagon. And so, you know, what you do in situations like that is you put the word out among all your musician friends. You know, you see who's busy, who's not, what keyboard players may be available. And we were kind of coming up empty for the most part. And then I realized there was one person that I hadn't called yet, the most obvious person in the world, a man of such perfect taste, a man who carries himself with such grace, both physically, musically, fashion-wise. The man has just got it going on. I called my buddy Rick Springfield. Wait, is he here? He's everywhere! That was supposed to be a little project. Yeah. Timing is everything there, bro. Anyway, so Rick says, dude, KC, I got your man. He's an amazing Hammond organist, great piano player, awesome harmony singer, and perhaps most importantly, a kind, caring, loving human being. So please, if you will, say hello on the grand piano to the happiest man in rock and roll, Derek Hilland. Still afraid to let it flow.
Jesus, he hasn't changed a bit. That could have been it.
So you guys might have noticed another new face up here with us, someone who just recently joined the REO Speedwagon touring family. After playing for 12 years with Elton John, we were fortunate enough that our good friend was ready to join us on bass. Say hello to Matt Bissonette.
Hello, Matt.
Well, Matt is well known for his musical abilities, for his sense of humor, for his all-around cool guy-ness. But most people don't, I didn't know. When he first joined the band, I had no idea that he was quite the expert meteorologist. Now, you may be asking yourself, why does it matter if there's a meteorologist in the band? And I will answer that question. And it is because we travel all through the summer months playing outdoor shows, and I'd like to have someone I can call to give me a very, very precise forecast on what to expect on any given night. So Matt, I called you today, and please tell the folks what you said.
Basically, you called me to join the band to be a meteorologist,
well,
first of all.
There's that.
But anyway, we've been touring all summer. We've been in the Midwest where 100% humidity. We've been smoking hot, and this is the best gig we've done all summer. This is the best weather in the world. I hope you guys appreciate how great this is. But anyway, they called me and they said, basically, we need you to tell us what the forecast is for the gigs. And so what I do every morning is I wake up around 7:30, and I check out my calculations that are showed up there, kind of nothing that you need to worry about. Just don't worry. But basically, Kevin will call me when he rolls out of the bus about 4:30 p.m. Anyway, when he's ready to go, he calls me and says, how's it looking tonight? And I can tell by the amount of beautiful people tonight that tonight's forecast is 100% chance of rock and roll. Come on!
just do what I